So when Noah was a little toddler, he came scooting down the stairs in our house, and he smelled like a stronger version of my wife. Let me explain. He had gotten into Jill's perfume, poison of all brands, and it was all over his mouth, all down his shirt, and we wondered how much he actually got into his mouth. So we called the 911 and the fire engines came, Noah liked that. And after a few minutes of discussion with them, we went on a little ambulance ride together. For Noah, it was a fun adventure. For me, it was a loop of prayer. Prayer for him, prayer for Jill, and just lifting to God the needs in that moment of fear and trouble. You know, trouble can move us in a couple of different directions, sometimes not always good. It moves us to fear in the moment and worry about the future. It moves us sometimes to depend upon ourselves. It moves us to think how we can fix our own problems. Of course, we're good North Americans. We can fix anything. But trouble comes for a reason, and I like what the Apostle Paul says in 2 Corinthians chapter 1. He writes a letter to the Corinthians, and he says these words. He was in trouble. He says, "We don't want you to be ignorant, brothers and sisters, about the troubles we experience in the province of Asia. We were under great pressure, far beyond our ability to endure, so that we despaired of life itself. Indeed, we felt we had received the sentence of death." So Paul was experiencing a lot of trouble, and he's writing to the church in Corinth and speaking about it. And then here's what he writes. This is so good. "But this happened that we might not rely on ourselves, but on God, who raises the dead. He has delivered us from such a deadly peril, and He will deliver us again. On Him, we have set our hope that He will continue to deliver us, as you help by your prayers." I love the direction that Paul goes with that. He encourages us to depend upon God and really to see our troubles and problems in life as moments to turn towards Him and not turn to ourselves. Listen, fear is real. I understand this. We want to encourage you to be the people of God who depend upon God. We want you to be turning to Him in prayer and asking for His help in these difficult times. So as we do this, let's be a people of prayer. Let me encourage you to just keep going to God with your fears and worries and concerns, and to also connect with brothers and sisters who need prayer as well. Ask them how they're doing and go to the Lord together. Let's be wide-eyed to the needs of others all around us. So let's do that together now and pray. And here's my prayer. God, I pray that you would help us be people who turn to you and find our hope and help in you, because you did and have raised the dead, and you will work in our midst. So we trust you today, Father, and ask you to work. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I want to remind you that starting next week, we'll be working through Praying the King's Agenda. It's an opportunity for us to be on the same page in a similar prayer devotional. And so we'll work on this. There's a time for you to reflect and record your thoughts, but we'll also be interacting via video and Facebook about this topic. So make sure you have one of these. We can get you one if you need one. Just call the church office. We won't be having church again this Sunday. We'll be listening to the governor and the president on their direction. So just stay tuned with all of that. We'll be communicating regularly, and we look forward to seeing you again.